Hello students, welcome to the English Literature class. In today's class, we shall cover a lesson, A Truly Beautiful Mind, from the literature book, Beehive. This is a lesson about the famous genius person, Albert Einstein. He was one of the greatest genius and the famous scientist. So, we always remember Albert Einstein to be a great genius and intelligent person. So this is a biography, and so we shall see different stages of his life and what was his great works. And as we see that, he is termed to be a truly beautiful mind. Let's find out why he is termed to be having a beautiful mind. So, first let us take up early life. He was born on 14th March 1879 at Ulm, Germany. From his infancy, he was found to be a freak boy. Freak means very abnormal, unusual behavior, unable to behave in a normal way. Outwardly, he had a large head. Then, he could not speak until 2.5 years. And when he began talking, he repeated each word twice. So we can find he was very, very unusual and common child. Secondly, he could not go along with his friends. He could not make friends. Other children could not go along with him. And so, he was found to be very boring for other children. So they termed him Brother Boring. Then, we find that from his childhood, he loved mechanical toys. He did not like to play with the human children. So he loved mechanical toys. In fact, when his younger sister Marja was born, he thought it was a beautiful toy. So he asked, "This toy is very beautiful, but where are its wheels?" So you can understand how mechanical his mind was. Then this proceeds to his schooling time. So as we find that he was quite abnormal from his childhood, so he could not learn in the initial stage. So teachers found that this child could not learn anything. He was not able to remember anything. So one day his headmaster remarked Einstein's father that whatever this child may try to learn, he cannot learn anything. In the future he cannot become anything worth. So no use sending him to school. So his parents were quite sad. However, mother thought the child could do something better. So mother somehow knew that the boy could do something other than studies. So she advised him to play violin music, and to her great pleasant surprise, the boy at 6 years started playing violin, and he became a famous violinist, great player. Then he was sent to high school in Munich, Germany. There he proved to be a good student, very bright student. Suddenly he proved that he was very good at every subject, getting good marks. Then there was one problem. He did not like the rules and regulations. He did not like that any rule and pressure should be pressed upon him. So he had a problem with the teachers, problem with the rules and regulations. He had a quarrel with the teachers, and eventually he had to leave the schooling for good. He did not want to study anyway. However, parents did not lose heart. They thought that the boy should be sent somewhere else other than in Germany. There his mind may change and he may study. So they sent him to Milan, Italy, and he was left there with his relatives. There they tried to persuade him to study. However, he said he would not study. Then he later agreed if he wanted to study, then he would not study in Milan also. He would study in the country where there is no strict rules and regulations. So he found out the place in Switzerland, that is the University of Zurich, and their rules and regulations were quite lenient. He adjusted himself very well. So he started studying there. There he found one student, one girl called Mileva Maric. She was from Serbia. Both of them became good friends. They fell in love. They wanted to marry. But his parents opposed because that girl was 3 years old, older than him. And secondly, she was very intelligent. Both loved the science, inventions. Parents apprehended that their marriage would not be successful because both were very intelligent. Then, in 1900, at the age of 21, he graduated, and as usual happens, soon after graduation, he remained unemployed for some time. He had a problem, but after 2 years, he secured a good job, and the job was as a technical expert in patent office in Bern. So he was very good there doing his job, and where he worked, he named his desk Bureau of Theoretical Physics. Why did he call this? As he worked, his work was to assess the inventions of other scientists. But along with that, he carried on secretly his own inventions. And that's why by 1905, he established one theory, famous theory, that is theory of relativity. Theory of relativity describes the relationship between mass and energy. And then again, their marriage took place with Mileva, and they had two sons. However, their marriage faltered, was not successful. In 1903, their marriage came to an end. They divorced, and at the same year, he married his own cousin Elsa. Now, later on, we find his great works, achievements. In 1915, he established another famous paper called General Theory of Relativity, and he became so famous, and eventually he proved that his theory was successful, correct, and became very famous, and it was called the scientific revolution in the world. In 1921, he was awarded Nobel Prize for Physics based on the theory of relativity. In 1933, in Germany, the Nazis became powerful, and in fear of Nazis, he had to emigrate to US because they would not tolerate the scientist and artist. So he had to emigrate, go to US. There he came to know that in 1938, these Nazis had developed a nuclear fission, and Einstein knew that it is very dangerous, and if it is used, it can destroy a large area. He told Franklin D. Roosevelt through a letter that if one bomb is exploded, it can destroy a big harbor and the surrounding area. And the president accepted this, understood. And US also continued the formation of atom bomb, and eventually during the Second World War, US dropped two bombs at Hiroshima and Nagasaki in Japan, and we know how destructive it was. Then, seeing the destructive consequence, Einstein said that in the future it should not be used for the destructive purpose, instead it should be used for the good and constructive purpose only. He proposed the world that there should be some world organization, world government that could help the world to lead a peaceful life, that would stop the use of atom bomb. And he worked to form the organization, and that's why he was called a world citizen, because he wanted the world to live peacefully. And in this way we find that Albert Einstein proved to be a great person in the world. For today's class, dear students, that's all. Thank you very much.